Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to discuss about Gartner Magic Quadrant in the Catch Up with Nags series. This is a report published by Gartner and how this report will help you to evaluate your technologies. That is what I'm going to discuss in this video. Let's check about what is Gartner Magic Quadrant. A Magic Quadrant is a series of market research reports published by the IT consulting firm Gartner. Okay, so basically the Gartner is a company, IT consulting firm. They do a lot of research and publish some reports on the some technologies. What they publish is like they perform qualitative data analysis methods to demonstrate market trends such as direction, maturity, and participants. So they consider different parameters, how this technology is progressing, that particular provider is providing, market trends, various factors they will consider, and then they arrive to this magic quadrant. So this is to understand the technology providers, the report, whatever they publish, and you might consider for a specific investment opportunities. So in this magic quadrant, they will place these providers, right? Whoever the providers of this technology, they will place it as leaders, niche, or some challenges, or another factor is there. So based on that, people who are looking for providers of that particular technology, they can easily choose from. That is the core concept behind this quadrant. So you can see here, this is the how the magic quadrant will look like. So they will place the different providers like Microsoft, consider the data analytics reporting provider or business intelligence report providers. Okay, then Microsoft will be a leader. I will show it to it. And there are different competitors like Tableau, Click, and Looker. And you can say IBM provides their own data analytics platform or BI platform. So they will place on different providers in each quadrant. So leader being the top, but having said that, we cannot blindly go for leaders. That is also there mentioned in their website. I will quickly go through it. So how we can see is like completeness of vision. This will be in this axis and ability to execute, right? How they are executing against their vision. That is what this magic quadrant says about. Let's quickly jump into their website. You can see here, positioning technology players within a specific market. So this is basically like you want to look for a provider. Say for example, you want to implement a cloud technology in your organization. There are a lot of providers and you need to choose one. It is very difficult to go through the internet or without any R&D, right? So they are here. They do a lot of research based on different parameters and they do the analysis. And finally, they publish this magic quadrant every year. So whoever wants to invest in the particular providers, they can check it out whether where they are. So you can see the disclaimer over here. Keep in mind that focusing on the leaders quadrant isn't always the best course of action. They also said saying someone we are positioned as leaders doesn't mean you need to go for. They are not recommending anyone from this quadrant. They just publish it based on the vision, whatever the particular provider provided, and whether they are accompanying or not. So then they also added like there are good reasons to consider market challenges as well. Those who are in challenges, you can also consider that quadrant people. And niche player may support your needs better than a market leader because they are niche players and whatever you request, they can customize it for you. They can do much more things for you. Whereas the leaders may not have ability to customize the tools for you. So that is what they mentioned. It all depends on how the provider aligns with your business goals. So This is about the quadrant, and they are given different definitions for leaders, visionaries, niche, and challenges. There are four quadrant, and each quadrant have the names, and it doesn't matter. There is no ranking 1, 2, 3, something like that. Within this quadrant, whoever falls, they becomes the leaders. But based on the position, they are accompanying more on their vision, right? So why I'm saying this magic quadrant? Of course, yes, the Power BI, whatever we have thought, Microsoft, that Power BI technology comes under magic quadrant for analytics and business intelligence platform. So now you may have a puzzle, who those who are learning, whether I am learning the best technology in the market. Yes, of course, this is the proof. And if you are not a learner, you are already doing in your organization. So Microsoft is the best, that is Power BI is the one of the leaders in this technology. And this is not only for Power BI. You are in the initial position, or whatever, maybe you are running your organization, or you are the decision maker to select some of the tools. So you can use this magic quadrant for deciding which tool to use or which technology to go for. So this is published on as of February 2021. And you can see other players in this analytics and business intelligence Tableau, everyone aware, and click. And there are a lot and lot of players. You can choose between them. And you can see here, view all magic quadrants. When you click on this, you can see there are different category technologies, basically. Now, this is what we have seen, business intelligence analytics platform. Now you can see, now you are going for cloud AI development, okay? Then you can choose this one and get the report from their Gartner. So this particular report is not published publicly, I think, but you can always request by using your official account. Then based on this, you can decide on. So it is useful for both those who are learning the technology. You can go by this quadrant, magic quadrant, so that whichever technology you choose, whether it is in trend or not, you can decide on. And those who are taking a decision to purchase this technology, you can trust this Gartner instead of blindly believing some of the blog post or some channels like. So I hope you understand the purpose of magic quadrant. You can use it in your future. Thanks for watching. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. And do remember that data is your asset.